I had a really strange dream last night that I cut all my hair off with like my beard trimmer. And I was talking to Aaron about it in my dream about how I really hope that this is just a dream and I didn't really do this because my hair looks stupid. What's up, dudes? Today is Sunday and it has been a wonderful day so far. This morning we had our last early service for the summer. So no more 8:15 worship until the first Sunday in August, which means sleeping in a little bit, which is wonderful. Which means the first thing that we do on Sunday morning is get together and study God's word, and then we have some worship, and then we have fellowship. It's going to make things nice and simple. Nice and easy. It's gonna be good for the summer. Today at the late service, we baptized three kids. Absolutely phenomenal. Really cute kids. It was good. And then after the service, I drove about an hour out southeast, past the Superstition Springs Mall. That family, the mom and dad of those kids, got married. But the thing is the mom didn't know that she was getting married until I started the wedding liturgy. It was my first ever surprise marriage, and it went really well. The new husband was convinced that this was a good idea, that she was gonna love it. All the family was in town for the baptisms anyway, and it just made perfect sense for them. And I was nervous. I didn't know. It could have gone, either way. I was trying to figure out like what set of bushes to slowly back into if things didn't go well. But it went really well. They were both choking up a little bit during their vows. It was a beautiful wedding in their backyard, really peaceful and serene setting. The family was awesome. So yeah, first surprise wedding in the books as a success. Ladies and gentlemen out there, maybe that can be a thing from now on. We'll see. I'm stopping to get some gas because my car's almost on E. I have a feeling that when I get home, I'm just gonna sit down on the couch and turn on Sherlock and not get up until the morning. I only got a couple hours sleep last night, and on days like that, it's better for me to just fast through and not eat anything on days like that because my cortisol and my insulin are already elevated from lack of sleep. They say if you don't sleep 6 hours in a night, you're pre-diabetic for the next 36 hours. And so I'm not gonna eat anything today. I'm just gonna kind of ride this one out. I'm not even hungry. But I'll just go to sleep tonight, wake up tomorrow, and have a good breakfast or something. But so for today, all I got for you is it was a good one, and it'll probably be a good night. I might sneak some footage in of my daughter in a little bit.
Hi. This is the part you're not gonna like, huh? Please be careful. Hi.
Hi,
Hi, buddy. Eloise.